We witnessed some incredibly encouraging signals that Super Heavy 7 is likely to be repositioned on the orbital launch mount. It has been a long and difficult journey to get to or closer to witnessing the very first and historic launch of the enormous Starship rocket. It appears both SPMTs that arrived yesterday are now under Booster 7 and are being loaded with counterweights. The move could happen as early as today for a lift to orbital launch mount to tomorrow during the scheduled road closure. If you recall from last week, the hydraulic power unit or HPU aero covers had been removed, and this week they have been reinstalled. Super Heavy Booster the 7th of May soon be lifted back onto the launch mount due to its heavy weight. Now, let's quickly shift gears and talk about a booster that lacks hydraulic power units, Booster 10. Booster 10 was finally fully stacked in the mega bay this week. To refresh your memory, all boosters up to and including Booster 7 had hydraulic power units that were used to provide well hydraulic power to gimbal the Raptor engines. However, boosters 9 and beyond, including Booster 10, do not have hydraulic power units, and instead use an electrically actuated gimbal systems for their Raptors. This reduces weight, removes complexity from the system, and is one less thing to break. Booster 10 will be worked on in the Mega Bay for the next few weeks and months, and once it's ready, we'll move into pre-flight testing, the first of which is cryoproofing. The interesting question is whether that cryoproof test will take place at the launch site. SpaceX installed the final piece of shielding on the side of the launch mount. SpaceX has yet to inject concrete into the leg extensions, and they appear to be a little late to the party here. In case you missed it, the orbital launch mount legs were initially installed in 2020, and were filled with concrete, before the vertical extensions were added in 2021. The deck of the orbital launch mount, which houses the booster and all of the hold downs, is directly on top of these vertical extensions. The extensions are now being filled 2 years after they were installed, which should give the orbital launch mount and its legs added strength, which will be required to withstand the force and weight of a fully fueled full Starship stack, plus the insane power of 33 Raptor engines, firing at 7,500 tons of thrust at liftoff. For the last few weeks, we've only seen road closures for transportation, but now we have road closures for this week that look like they're for testing. Could this be Booster 7 being lifted back onto the launch mount? It doesn't seem like there's much left to test, so is launch really going to be soon finally for real this time? Now let's talk about, immediately this flight's becoming the focus of the whole world's attention. With 200 countries and thousands of newspapers reporting on the launch, well, this isn't the first time. So this leads to some. What's the reason this rocket launch makes the whole world pay attention, and why Starship's first orbital flight is very important for SpaceX? The first orbital flight will be the culmination of years of hard work and dedication. A successful flight will be a significant milestone for the company, and it will cement SpaceX's position as a leader in the space industry. The first Starship orbital flight tests the performance of the rocket's engines and other systems during launch. Once in orbit, the Starship will need to perform various maneuvers, such as adjusting its trajectory and speed, in order to perform its mission. The first orbital flight will test the Starship's maneuverability in space, and provide data on how well it performs in this environment. The Starship's ability to perform a controlled re-entry and landing is crucial for its reusability. The first orbital flight will provide data on how well the Starship performs during re-entry and landing, including how well it handles the heat generated during re-entry. During re-entry, the Starship's heat shield will be tested to see how well it performs in protecting the rocket and its contents from the intense heat generated during re-entry. The flight will provide valuable data on the performance of the heat shield, which will be used to improve it for future missions. The Starship's fuel efficiency is critical for its ability to carry humans and cargo to space and back. The first orbital flight will provide data on the Starship's fuel efficiency during launch, orbit, and re-entry, which will be used to optimize its performance for future missions. Clearly, this flight is considered to be a huge new development step for the company. The orbital flight is the first time that SpaceX has produced a full-size prototype, with two integrated parts together. Starship and Super Heavy will be nearly 120 meters tall, when stacked for launch. It's the largest monster on the planet ever built, simultaneously with this mission. Unlike the flight test, the altitude is only about 10 kilometers above sea level at current. Land Ship 24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 will make the longest flight ever. It will fly out of Earth's orbit, flying 3/4 of the way around the Earth. Because this is the longest flight, the flight time is the longest as well. This is a flight that's considered a new leap for SpaceX. Second, the Starship's first orbital test flight, though audacious in scale. SpaceX intends to collect as much data as possible during flight to quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime, and that's extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally. This data will anchor any changes in vehicle design or conception of operations after the first flight and build better models for them to use in internal simulation. Third, this orbital flight will help SpaceX solidify its lead in the space race. Previously, people knew that SpaceX was famous for its Falcon 9, which is a partially reusable rocket that has saved a lot of money and time for the company with every launch. However, seeing some limitations that Falcon 9 could not bring to the company. If Starship succeeds, SpaceX would further solidify its lead in the space race, becoming the first company to be able to build a fully reusable rocket in history of space. The first Starship orbital flight test the performance of the rocket's engines and other systems during launch. Once in orbit, the Starship will need to perform various maneuvers, such as adjusting its trajectory and speed, in order to perform its mission. The first orbital flight will test the Starship's maneuverability in space, and provide data on how well it performs in this environment. The Starship's ability to perform a controlled re-entry and landing is crucial for its reusability. The first orbital flight will provide data on how well the Starship performs during re-entry and landing, including how well it handles the heat generated during re-entry. During re-entry, the Starship's heat shield will be tested to see how well it performs in protecting the rocket and its contents from the intense heat generated during re-entry. The flight will provide valuable data on the performance of the heat shield, which will be used to improve it for future missions. Elon Musk has been very vocal about his vision for humanity to become a multi-planetary species. He believes that this is necessary for the survival and progress of our species. The Starship project is the embodiment of this vision, and the first orbital flight will be a significant step towards achieving it. SpaceX has already generated a lot of interest in space exploration through its previous achievements. The success of the first orbital flight of the Starship will further increase public interest in space exploration and inspire a new generation of space enthusiasts. The Starship rocket is a massive undertaking by SpaceX, with a goal of creating a fully reusable launch system that can carry humans and cargo to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. However, before it can be used for human missions, it needs to be tested in orbit. The first orbital flight will prove that the Starship is capable of achieving orbit and performing maneuver in space, which will be crucial for its future missions. One of the key features of the Starship rocket is its reusability. SpaceX aims to make space travel more affordable by reusing the same rocket multiple times.